Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as the salvage value. Salvage value is the important part of depreciation. When you calculate depreciation, you deduct salvage value and you divide by the number of years of the term of the life or the life of the asset. So let's understand this in the complete detail format. Salvage value or the scrap value is the value of any assets after its useful life is over. So let's say you bought an asset today and after 5 years, let's say that asset it's not actually in operational state. So it has almost lost its useful life now. So after that, when you sell it as a scrap, so what is going to be its salvage value? That's what we are discussing here. Let's understand this in a detail format. First, we'll understand the nitty-gritty of what is the salvage value. See, salvage value or the scrap value is valued of an asset, is the value of an asset after its useful life is over. Like for example, if you buy a machinery and if of a company and it has a life of, let's say, 5 years, and at the end of the 5 years, its value is, let's say, only 5,000. Right, at the end, let's say its value is only 5,000. So 5,000 over here is called as the salvage value. Right, now when a company purchases an asset, like first it calculates its salvage value of the asset, and thereafter, you know, this value is deducted from the total cost of the assets, and then the depreciation is charged on the remaining amount. So it is very difficult to calculate this value. The normal practice is to depreciate the assets on the total cost basis, considering its value as nil. Now, there is one issue with this concept. Since this value is deducted before the depreciation is charged, what happens is that people can use it as in a fraudulent manner. Now, how? Let's understand. See, they basically can deduct more salvage value. As a result of the amount of the depreciation would be reduced. And that means the profit of the company will also increase significantly, right? Now, the another name of the salvage value is also known as the scrap value. It is also known as the scrap value. And this is mere estimate only. No one knows what a piece of equipment or machinery would cost after, let's say, 10 years. No one knows that. The piece of the asset may end up in a junkyard as well, right? Let's take a salvage value example to make you understand in a more detailed format. Let's say there is this company called KG Inc. It has purchased an equipment. Let's say the equipment costing is $1 lakh, right? So the company finds out that the useful life of the asset of this equipment is, let's say, 10 years. I'm writing over here as the life. At the end of the 10 years, now the value of the equipment would be, at the end of the 10 years, it would be 10,000 only. The salvage is 10,000 as a part of the scrap value. So the over here, if the salvage is 10,000, that means your scrap value will also be 10,000. So now, as we know that the value of the equipment is 10,000, the depreciation of the equipment should be calculated something like this, is equal to bracket your equipment, that will be your equipment cost, less your salvage value, divide by the life of the asset. Once you do that, you have your answer, 9,000 as a part of the depreciation, right? So let's have a look at the formula of the salvage value. The salvage value, which will denote as S over here, it will be calculated something like this. S, that is your salvage value, is equal to P bracket 1 minus I bracket close, and it will be raised to Y. Raised to small y. So P over here, it denotes the original cost of the asset. I denotes your depreciation, and Y in our example, which is raised to Y, is the number of, so to find out the scrap value, you first need to make sure that the depreciation rate should be determined. Along with that, you know, you also need to know how many years the asset will last, that is the useful life of the asset. Let's take a detailed example on this. Let's say there's a company again, let's say it's KG Inc. And it has some detail which has, let's say it has bought an asset of $1 million. And they figured out that the useful life of the asset would be around, let's say, 20 years. Life is 20 years. And the depreciation rate on which they will depreciate of the asset would be 20%. Let's say the depreciation rate is standing at 20%. So what we need to find out over here is the salvage value of the KG Inc. just purchased. That is the asset which they just purchased. So in this example, we have been given the original price of the asset, which is standing at 1 million, the useful life of the assets, which is 20 years, and the depreciation, which is prorated at 20%. So the salvage value, which by applying this particular formula, we will have something like this, that will be is equal to 1 minus your depreciation is 20%, so it will be 0.2, right, of 1 million. We need to put this in a bracket because we have thing called raise to number of years, which is 20 years as a life. So this is our answer in terms of it will be, this is closely to 11,529. Yeah, 529 million. So not million, it is just $11,529. Right. So this is the example of how we found the salvage value. That is 1 minus the depreciation, right? That is 20%. Sorry, over here we use the depreciation. This 0.2 is your depreciation, which is 20%. So the depreciation rate divided by the number of years. Now, what if the salvage value of any asset goes to zero? See, what if the salvage value of your asset at the end of the useful life is zero? What should we do? What should one do then? See, as per the US income tax regulation, while depreciating any asset, you need to assume that the scrap value of the asset would be zero. You have to assume that. Now, if you assume that the scrap value or the salvage value is, let's say, zero, then we can get the value. We can find that at the end of the useful life, we can get the value. We can account it as a gain of the company instead of estimating it far behind. Now, as a result, there would be no estimation error, okay, in finding out the scrap value, and no one would be able to use this value as an excuse to encourage or support fraudulent practices. Now, how is this scrap value seen in the cost accounting? See, remember one thing. In cost accounting, the idea of the scrap value is slightly different than that of the cost in the financial accounting. In cost accounting, the scrap value is the raw material of the product that the manufacturer will sell off as a scrap. That means that if it has nothing to do with the obsolescence of the assets, rather it's new raw material that are no value to the manufacturing company. So on the final end of the conclusion, I'll say that there is a confusion between the salvage value and the scrap value and the residual value. These are the three terms, right? However, if you see, the scrap value and the residual value are just the other names of the salvage value in accounting. So to summarize, it is the value of any assets after its useful life is over, and scrap value is an estimated figure, so it can be calculated if you can determine the depreciation rate and the useful life. So in the US, for the purpose of tax purpose, the depreciation is calculated assuming the scrap value as zero.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.